your game that when you was in Portland?
I just got experience in big games, big time moments. Just getting back on the court for about 80-85 games last season was big for my overall growth as a player. So hopefully I can bring that at the beginning of this year.
What did you miss by not being here that one year?
I just missed a great organization, great team. You know what I'm saying? This team continue to build with the young pieces they have. And you can see Luka getting better as the season went along. And KP getting back here, getting back healthy. It should be a good step in the right direction for this franchise.
Was it a no-brainer that you was going to come back here?
I wouldn't say a no-brainer, but like I said at media day, it was like the first time I had a lot of options free agency-wise. So I was taking everything into account, and this was the best fit overall from on the court to off the court.
Given how tough the West is, how important is it for you guys to get off to a good season start? I know you don't want to look past the first game, but just to go in with some momentum.
I mean, you never want to have a slow stretch in the Western Conference, no matter what point of the season. But you want to get off to a good start, obviously. But this is not the end of the world if you don't get off to a good start. You got to be consistent throughout a full 82 game season. That's the thing I learned last year. We got off to a good start, then we had a long like month and a half of bad basketball and lost a lot, and then we got it back together and ended up being a 3 seed last year. So it's a lot of ups and downs throughout the NBA season, and I mean, for a lot of young guys on this team, that's what we have to learn, just to stay focused, even when we have bad weeks of basketball, that we can turn around.
What's the person most about KP?
I like his attitude. He's serious about the game. He's real competitive. You can tell he's hungry to get back out there. You know, I can relate to him and how he missed the game for over a year. And he's back out here healthy. He's not taking any days off really. And he's, like I said, his attitude about the game is real serious, real professional like, and seems like he's wise beyond his years. So he's a fun guy to play with.
What are your thoughts on Luka being on the same team as opposed to matching up against
him? He can play. He can play. His basketball IQ is unmatched. He sees the floor better than a lot of people in the league right now. And as we get on the court more together, I've been on the playing against him mostly in practice, haven't been on the same team as him as much, but hopefully as the season goes along, we get more court time together and we can continue to build that bond.
What opens up for you with those two out there? You should be open wide open.
It's a lot of space. I don't think I ever be or just guys leaving me wide open, but hopefully I can create space for those guys by my presence out there, and obviously they're going to have the ball a lot, and they're both willing and great passers, so it should be a lot of fun to play with those guys as the season goes along, and they're aggressive, so they're going to get a lot of attention.
Is there a better trash talker than Courtney Lee?
I love C-Lee, man. C-Lee's a competitive guy. He brings it hard, hard work and practice every single day, and he lets you know about it at the same time, so he's a vet that brings a lot to this team. No matter what amount of minutes he plays throughout the season, he continues to work hard every day, and that's the guy you need on your team.
Last week, Courtney said the key to getting to the playoffs is beating all the bad teams and splitting with the good teams.
Yeah.
Is that the way you see it?
Yeah, exactly. First of all, you got to take care of your home court as much as possible. And I think that was our formula last year in Portland. I learned we went on the road a lot and beat the bad teams, and we won at home. And against the good teams, our record wasn't very good at all throughout the regular season. But, we were a 3 seed because we took care of business in the games we should win. So. I think that's the focus throughout a long season is beat the bad teams and then compete and try to go on the road and steal some games against good teams. But you got to do your job, against the non-playoff teams.
How has the transition been so far?
It's been fine. It's been fine, man. Just getting back in the swing of things, just learning the system. It's the hardest thing is just trying to get to know the lingo coming from here to Terry Stott's system where – similar system, but the lingo is completely different, and then trying to relearn it over again is the hardest thing. But once we're out there on the floor, it's pretty comfortable.
Is this the best you've ever seen the West?
I haven't seen the West yet, so I don't know. The West is deep. It's not too many guaranteed wins, like it has been sometimes in the past. I don't feel like, but I mean, you never know throughout once the season gets started. You never know how these teams are going to shake out on the floor. I mean, a lot of teams are good on paper, but I don't think it's a dominant team like we've seen the Warriors in the past. So a lot of people have confidence coming into the year.